Hey guys, it is Tamara. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel. Welcome back. Today we're going to be talking about how to deal with a manipulator over the holiday. And you know, this is a topic that a lot of people are looking for. I did a Google search using Google keywords, and the most searched keyword for holiday 2020 was how to deal with family. I thought that was pretty interesting. One of the reasons why I think that's the most searched term right about now is because families are difficult to deal with in and of themselves, right? And then you add the holiday on top of that, and then you add COVID on top of that, and it just makes it feel so unbearable. So in today's video, I'm gonna talk just a little bit about how to manage a manipulator. We just talked about covert and overt narcissism and what that looks like. So these tips can be applied to that video as well. Let's go ahead and jump in. Thank you so much for coming back to my channel for those who are subscribed. And for those who are new, I encourage you to hit that subscribe button so you can stick around with this and be a part of our growing and validating community. And in case you don't know me, let me go ahead and briefly introduce myself. My name is Tamara, and I'm an internationally and board certified trauma therapist, but I'm also a licensed mental health therapist. And I specialize in treating children, adolescents, and families, as well as adults who are dealing with a trauma history or some kind of grief and loss and transition. So what you're going to get on this channel is a lot, and most, if not all, of what I talk about has a foundation of trauma. So just know that in every topic that you see on this channel, it has something to do with trauma. There's a foundation of trauma somewhere. So, you know, when you think about the holiday, I just wonder what emotions and what thoughts come to you. You know, I'm sure it's anxiety and it's stress and it's uncertainty and it's some fear, and you know, maybe there's some ambiguity for you where, you know, you're not clear on what you're feeling. You're not clear on, you know, what you want to do or how you want to celebrate the holiday coming up. Maybe you haven't thought about it at all, kind of like me. Maybe you're just, you know, too overwhelmed and too busy to really think about the holiday and process it and all the new stressors that's going to come along with it. A lot of people are struggling. My clients are struggling. People who consult with me are struggling. And if I'm honest, I'm struggling as well with the whole thought of, you know, any kind of holidays. This year we've dealt with a lot. We've dealt with a lot of police brutality. We've dealt with a lot of racially motivated news reports and political stunts, and we've dealt with race-based murder and loss. We have dealt with COVID. We've lost family members to COVID. We've lost family members just to natural causes. I lost my grandmother this past April unexpectedly, and she was the hub of our family. You know, she held everybody together, and you know, when someone like that dies, the whole family kind of loses their place. So I lost my grandmother. Then I got COVID in May. I was a long hauler, and now I'm back onto the journey of health. But then on top of that, I relocated my practice, and there's just a lot going on for us, you know, and a lot of personal things that we're trying to manage. And so to think about a holiday just doesn't feel natural. It doesn't feel normal. It doesn't feel safe, if you will. You know, I think it's only when we can feel emotional and psychological safety that we have some kind of hope and motivation for a holiday, for a celebration. But without that psychological, emotional safety, you know, there's no sense in thinking about a holiday because you're just too busy defending yourself against the evils of our time. So, you know, so I don't blame you if you're like me and you haven't really processed the holidays. But for those who have, you know, I'm sure you're feeling overwhelmed and feeling stressed with how to manage it, especially with having to be careful with, you know, who's around you and the numbers of people you have in your space. Can you imagine how much more stressful it is to have a manipulator and a covert or an overt narcissist in your space around this time? So I'm going to talk about some ways, and specifically six ways that you can handle these kind of individuals. So let's just go ahead and jump into those tips, okay? So the first thing that I suggest if you're dealing with a very difficult personality that I talk about right up in this video here on covert and overt narcissism, the first thing I suggest that you do is avoid at all costs matching wits, matching language and behavior, words and matching lifestyles. You know, individuals who are complicated and they're dramatic and, you know, they have some histrionic traits. You know, they are very argumentative and confrontational. They challenge you, they compete with you, right? Those kind of people really are looking for the grand opportunity to kind of perform. Okay, and holiday time is usually that time for them to do so. So I suggest what you do in a situation like that is avoid matching words, wits, and behaviors. Avoid matching lifestyles. I just got married. What about you? I just had a 5-year-old. What about you? I just had a child. What about you? My 5-year-old is going to daycare. What about yours? He's going to the best daycare in the city. I just got a new job and a raise. How's things going for you? Avoid that. Don't even go there, right? It's like you're boasting, you're being arrogant in that moment, and you're just trying to elevate yourself over that narcissistic and unhealthy manipulator. So just don't even go there, right? Avoid matching words, matching wits, and matching lifestyles. Okay, don't feed into what they want from you. The next thing that I suggest is hold the boundary and don't budge. Hold the boundary. And what I mean by that is you want to be able to keep that physical and psychological space. The minute you abandon your boundary, that's the minute that they're coming in to harm you. They're like sharks, okay? So these individuals, you want to make sure that you hold the boundary. The minute you let your guard down is the minute they're going to come in and try to manipulate you and harm you and lie to you and, you know, maybe do all kind of other things to you, right? Sometimes manipulators and narcissists or problematic individuals really try to invade your space. They try to intimidate you physically, right? By standing too close to you or standing up on your heels or, you know, standing and towering over you if you're a shorter individual, right? So what you want to do is hold that boundary. Make sure they don't get that close to you physically, and make sure that you don't allow them in psychologically and emotionally as well, because at that point, they've won. So don't let it happen. Okay. The third thing I suggest is make space for yourself. Okay. To think. If you have to leave that dinner and go outside on the porch and just drink a cup of tea and just kind of think and process, go do it. If you need to go to the restroom and stand there for a little bit and just fix your hair, look in the mirror, scroll through your phone, do it. You're not obligated when you're dealing with narcissistic and problematic people to be in their environment. So find some way to minimize their impact on your life. And one way to do that is to hold the boundary and don't budge. Okay, and that can be, you know, anytime during that time, maybe that you're celebrating with your family, right? It could be at the very beginning of the celebration, as soon as you get there. It could be midways, it could be at the end. Whatever, make sure that you decompress and do that in a place where you can get away. So make room for yourself to think. Okay. The next is, you know, I encourage you to only engage with them on demand. Okay. The minute you decide to engage with them on demand is the minute you can correctly assert yourself when you need to. Okay. So here's what I mean by that. If you engage with them because you feel obligated to, you're going to feel drained. You're going to feel manipulated. You're going to feel kind of weakened by their defenses, by their defense mechanisms, by their behaviors, by their manipulation, by their narcissism and arrogance and boasting. So to kind of defend yourself against that, okay, it's easier for you to just communicate with them on demand. When they decide to speak to you, go ahead and speak to them, right? When they decide to, you know, try to engage you in a conversation, go ahead and respond, but make sure that you're doing it under the pretense, okay, that you're going to disengage at a later time, right? You don't have to be obligated. You're not obligated. You don't have to be forced to deal with them the entire time that you are celebrating with your family, right? So create some space for yourself, as I said in the last tip, and make sure that you only engage with them when you need to. That's really what I'm saying here. All right. The next thing that I suggest, and the final thing that I suggest, is consider not dealing with them at all, right? You can either not go, or you can minimize the time that you're there, or you can completely avoid them during the time, right? So consider that. You know, you're not obligated. Again, you're an adult. You're not obligated, again, to be around anybody that's unhealthy for you. And I think it's okay to say to your family member, whoever you're going to spend Thanksgiving and Christmas with, you know what? This is not healthy for me. I can't do it. Can you please, you know, just understand, you know, I'm only going to be there for 30 minutes, or can you understand that I'm only going to be there after that person leaves, or, you know, I ask for your patience, I'm not going to be there this time. It's a gracious and correct way to do that. So I encourage you to graciously bow out if you need to, graciously limit your time, or try to avoid that person as much as you can. Okay, guys, I hope that this is helpful for you. Some of these tips may be helpful in various areas of your life, not just holiday time, but specifically for our intent and purposes. This is in relation to trying to spend the holiday season with somebody who's difficult. So I hope these tips are helpful. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button and that thumbs up button. It helps other people find the video. And if this video was helpful, please let me know in the comment section below. I will create more videos for you moving forward of this magnitude, or of this fashion, I should say. All right, guys, I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.